Hi! Since version 2022.10 of Home Assistant, it is possible to store data in Google Sheets. I will show you how in this video. One of my viewers asked me a while ago if it would be possible to save events in a Google Sheet. At that time, it was a bit difficult to do so, but since version 2022.10, it's quite easy to store data in Google Sheets. I will show you how to set it up and how you can use it in an automation. You can also find the manual on this webpage. But before we move on, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. I need your support so that I can keep creating these videos for you. First, we have to make sure that we create developer credentials to allow Home Assistant access to your Google account. First, we go to the Google Developers Console, which is this link, and the link is in the description below. We are going to pretend that we do not have a project yet. I already have one, but we're going to create a new project. So I'm clicking on here and I'm going to click on new project, and this project is going to be project Home Assistant. And clicking on create. Now the project gets created. And now we are going to the Google Developers Console to enable Google Drive API and Google Sheets API. So I'm going to click on Enable API, and I'm going to say Enable Google Drive API, and I'm going to do the same for the Google Sheets API. So that's another link. I'm going to paste the link over here. Now I'm in the Google Sheets API. I'm clicking on Enable API. I click on Enable, and it is enabled. Now I'm going to the left sidebar and I'm going to API and services, and within API and services I'm going to credentials, and now I'm going to click on the OAuth consent screen. I'm selecting external, I'm selecting create, and I'm going to give this an app name. Home Assistant. I'm going to select my email address. Now I'm scrolling down and I'm going to enter the same email address here. And I'm going to click save and continue. Now we have been taken to the scopes page and I do not have to fill in anything here, so I can just click on save and continue. And now we are going to the optional info page, and I'm going to click also on save and continue here. Now we're scrolling down and I'm going to click on back to dashboard. Now we are going back to the OAuth consent screen. We are already there and you see that it's in testing mode. So we are first going to make sure that it's in production mode. So we are going to click on publish app, push to production, confirm. Now we go to credentials and we are going to click on create credentials, and we are going to select OAuth client ID. The application type is web application, and we're going to give this credential set a name. For instance, Home Assistant Credentials. And we're going to add an authorized redirect URL. So we click on add URI and we paste the following line here. The link is in the description below, and then we click on create. And now we are going to copy our client ID and our client secret in a text file. Now we click OK. And now we are going to double check that the Google Drive API has been automatically enabled. So we are going to library on the left side. We are going to search for Google Drive API. Click it. Click Google Drive API. And if it's not enabled, then enable it here. And I'm going to do the same for the Google Sheets API. So I'm going back. I'm going back again. Now search Google Sheets API. Click. And you see that this one is already enabled. So that's fine. So now everything is enabled in the Google Developers Console, and now we can set up Home Assistant. Now that we've set up the developer credentials, we have to set up Google Sheets in Home Assistant. It might be that you will get an error during setup, and that is mostly because there are already application credentials stored in Home Assistant for Google Sheets. In that case, you first have to remove these. I will first show you where you can remove this, and after that we will install the Google Sheets integration. Let's go to Settings, then we go to Devices and Services, then we click on the three dots over here, and here you see an option Application Credentials. If you see an application credential for your Google Sheets here, then please remove this. So I'm going to remove this, and it's removed. Now we can add Google Sheets. This is optional, so if you didn't see a Google Sheets credentials line here, then you're fine. So let's go again to Settings, Devices and Services. And now we are going to add the integration. So I'm going to click Add Integration. I'm going to search for Google. Click Google. Click Google Sheets. And now you can fill in the information that you also filled in the Google Developers Console. So the name is Home Assistant Credentials. Then we are going to paste the OAuth client ID and secret ID that we put in our text file. And now I'm clicking Add. And now it will ask me to log in into my Google account. So I will do that. Clicking Continue. I'm entering the Home Assistant URL. In most cases, it will be the URL that you already see here. In my case, it's a little bit different. So I will change this in my own name. I'm going to click Save. I'm going to click Link Account. And now Google Sheets is successfully integrated in Home Assistant. So I'm going to click on Finish Now. And you see that I have a Google Sheets integration in Home Assistant. Now, let's see what happens in our Google Drive. For that, we go to Google Drive. So I open a new tab and I'm going to drive.google.com. And you see there is a new document here. And if I double click it, you see that I have a Google Sheets document here. And that Google Sheets document has one worksheet, which is called Sheet 1. And let's create another one. And let's give this a name. Smart Home Junkie. So now I have a Google Sheet with two worksheets, Sheet 1 and Smart Home Junkie. And now we can start filling this sheet with data from Home Assistant. Google Sheets is now installed in Home Assistant. Let's test it in the developer tools to see if we can add data to our Google Sheet. We are going to developer tools, we're going to services, and the service that we can use now is Google Sheets, Append to Sheet. What we can do here is search for the integration, it's Google Sheets, and we can choose a worksheet within our Google Sheet. And in our case, that is either Sheet 1 or Smart Home Junkie. Or we can just leave this blank and then it will default to the first sheet in the document. And the data that we put in the sheet has the following format. So every sheet has columns and rows. We start with the column name. So let's say the column name is device. And then we're going to say the value in this column is motion sensor office, for example. And then the next column we are going to name temperature. And the value is, for instance, 20. So now I'm going to click call service. And if this button turns green and everything went well, so it turned green, let's see how our sheet looks. And now you see that in the sheet, I have a created date, I have a device column, and I have a temperature column. And the device is motion sensor office, and the temperature is 20. So that works. We've seen that the Google Sheets integration is working. I'll just show you one more thing, and that is how you can use it in an automation and add actual data from a sensor to your Google Sheet. For creating this automation, we are going to Settings, we are going to Automations and Scenes. We're going to Create Automation, and we are going to start with an empty automation. Now let's say for this example, I want to record every time when there's motion or no motion in the office. We're going to add a trigger. And the trigger will be a device in this case. Let's say office motion sensor. Let's say office motion sensor start detecting motion. And I'm going to give this a trigger ID. Motion detected. And we are going to add another trigger. Again, device, office motion sensor. And let's say office motion sensor stop detecting motion. And we're going to give it a trigger ID, motion stopped. Now we are going to actions. We're going to add an action. And that is going to be an if-then action. So we're adding a condition. If triggered by motion detected, then we want to add information to our Google Sheet. So I'm going to say add action. The action is a call service. The service is the same service that we used in the example, which is Google Sheets append to sheet. The integration is Google Sheets. This time we're going to say the worksheet is Smart Home Junkie. And the first column is motion type. And we're going to say detected. And then we're going to say add else, add action. Also call service when motion is not detected. So we're going to say again sheets, append to sheet. Sheet is again Google Sheets. The worksheet is Smart Home Junkie. And the data is now motion type, which is our column header. And we are going to say stopped. Let's save this. Give the automation a name. Sheets register motion, save, and now let's go to our Google Sheets and see if this gets filled with the data from our motion detector. And yes, as we can see, it is getting filled because there was motion detected just now and it's stopped. And if I move again, then probably it will be detected again. And now you see that our Google Sheet is filled automatically with information. You can, of course, fill this with more information. For instance, also value. So let's expand this automation so that it also stores the value of the motion sensor. So we're going back to Home Assistant and we're going back to the actions. And then in the then, we are going to edit our Google Sheets append to sheet service call. And we are going to add a temperature here. So the second column name will be temperature. And we are going to add some YAML in this line. And that is this YAML code. States sensor dot office motion sensor temperature quote. Then I'm going to make this a float 0. Like this. So what you're seeing here is now that a column temperature will be added to our Google Sheet and it will be filled with the value of our motion sensor temperature sensor, and it also will be converted to a float. So let's save this. Now let's see what happens in our sheet. And let's see if I move, if we get a new column header. Yes, we have the column header temperature, and you see that the value of the motion sensor temperature sensor is also filled in our Google Sheet. So this works. This is how you can use Google Sheets in Home Assistant. I hope that I managed to explain how you can connect Home Assistant to Google Sheets and how you can send data to your Google Sheet. I want to thank everyone who has supported me in making these videos and tutorials so far. I could never have done this without you. Thank you. You can support me through Patreon, Ko-fi, or by joining my channel. If you also want to support me, look in the description of this video for the links. With that, you make it possible that I can continue to make these videos for you. Oh, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit the notification bell. I will see you soon. Bye bye.